Nate. How's life?
I don't know. It's all right. I've been dealing with some things like every human being and really didn't sleep much last night. I'm sorry. That's fine. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. A little break.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the Nathan Experience Podcast. It has been a bit, but we're back. And kind of get kind of a redo, I guess, a reboot of the Nathan Experience Podcast, as now it's going to be more of, I get to like chill for like 30 minutes. I get to talk about whatever for like 30 to 40 to an hour, whatever my topic is. I think I'm going to keep it at 30 minutes. I think it's just the right amount. But yeah, that people will enjoy, especially if it's on YouTube. You will be able to get it on most other podcasting networks. I'll link them all. Well, I'll link the Anchor one in the description, and then you'll find all the other links there. Actually, no, I'm not going to do the Anchor. I'm sorry. I'm going to link the Spotify one. So the Spotify one will be available down there, so go check it out. But to this video is me talking about what YouTubers kind of influenced me to start YouTube. Because I want to do video, why I started YouTube. I want to do that video is still going to happen. But it's what YouTubers influenced me to do YouTube. Not in a real specific order, but there are a couple rules. One, no music. Music's a whole other podcast episode. Actually, I think I have it set for the video's already shot, so it's going to be a Music Mondays this episode. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. But if you don't want Music Mondays, it's my music review on Mondays. It's up here. The Undertaking Funeral Songs review should be coming out then. Or it's already come out. But yeah, no music quarter. No music. Try to keep it one person per, I guess, category. Just so I don't overlapping. And there are a couple that might overlap. I don't know. And again, no music quarter. So let's get into it. Manda the Jedi, she is from Canada. I don't remember how I found her, she's really known for covering the Twilight novels and movies from that, just that area. A time like from 2005 to like 2013. If I really like how she does it, she goes deep into it. She's not afraid to say something's bad. She's not afraid to tell an author, hey, this is kind of weird. But I don't know. That's what I really liked about her content. Very down to earth. She's someone I love to do a podcast with. She has podcasts, actually. But yeah, I really like her content. Influenced me to do movie reviews. Some of them are still up on this channel. Some of them are actually getting movie reviews. Floppies and Flying Box. So please go check that out. Next up, Benjamin Babish. It's, I like his videos just because of his aesthetic. And I kind of made a joke of him with the Anti-Miss Ramen character. Even though he's not really Babish. He's just me being like another cook show host. But, like, the influence of Benji Babish is there. I just like his aesthetic, how the videos are this nice, smooth atmosphere. And just how he lays out his videos and everything. It's really nice. It's great when I'm editing and I put on one of his videos. It's just very soothing. And some of the stuff he makes, just I want to make myself. But, yeah. The next one is, Fred Raider. If you don't know Fred Raider is, they've animated some stuff. They worked on, Fairly Odd Parents and a couple other things. Also, they make some of their own shows, like, Big Game Papa Cat, and I think Bravest Warriors. Sure, alright. But I found them. I think it was the it was the Cartoon Conspiracy videos that one of them was doing on the weekends. I really like that. Like, is this thing this? Who are doing movies, parents, stuff like that. And I just really liked how those videos were set out, and just like, it's this office vibe with nerds. Or like, they have some other channels like Getting the Robots, all the anime stuff, and Cartoon Hangover, which I think those Cartoon Conspiracy videos were on. But I lumped those three kind of together because they're all the same. I just really like those videos. Comic Pop. Comic Pop was one of the first YouTube channels I actually found. Specifically comic book channels, like there was Comic Swing, and there was Comic Story, which I had seen before Comic Pop. I really, like, I like those videos, but, like, I like Comic Pop a lot. Because it's three dudes, or four guys, talking about a comic book each week. Something one guy really likes, or doesn't like, makes him even better if he doesn't like it. And just like the Witty Banner, the discussions they have for like an hour, it's really neat. I really like how that goes. And I kind of did it with a Skillet review of a book. That's all I kind of got. I just really like that type of video layout. Decker Shadow. One of the other movie reviewers that are on here. I really like how it said of how manic he is, like how much energy he has in his videos. Then it's just him sitting down in front of a camera somewhere, much like what I'm doing right now. And just reviewing. Sometimes he has his friend do it with him, and I just like how he does these like summer specials. Just I've done a couple. I did the Does the Crunch Tuesdays, I did the Skillet September. Another one will be coming out soon. I don't know if I'm going to do one this December. I might wait till the summer. If I do one in summer or one in December, I think that's my goal. I just really like how he does those summer specials. And I like his podcast, Live Arts. It's another one I like listening to when I work or when I'm editing videos. It's like 3 hours long. So it's great if I'm on a road trip as well. So. Implicitly Pretentious. I think I found him, I think, shortly after Endgame came out, and it's him taking a topic from a movie and discussing it. He did it for Endgame, talking about, how, trauma deals with people. Then WandaVision came out, same thing, and then kind of when Falcon and Soldier came out. I really like how the videos laid out. They're very simple to get to the point. I like how they're broken up with clips from the movies and transitions. It's really neat. I really like how it's set out. Jaden Animations and Outer Ones Out. These two I found. I really like that it's it's them animated talking about live stores. I really like that. I like Outer Ones Out for his Subway videos. I used to work at a Subway. I did that for like 3 years. And then Jaden just talking about travel and life stuff I really like. And you just see them. They don't divulge a lot about their personal life, but they do talk about these stories, and I really like that. They're creating this nice barrier. And I think that's what I'm going to do with the Nathan Experience podcast, talking about stuff like that. Maybe a Subway video will come out. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, that's what I really like about that. Jack's Blade was a channel I found trying to get a decent workout regimen. What I was using was not really working for me. But he did it in the lens of, here's cartoons and stuff like that. Well, if you want to get built like this cartoon character, how do I do that? And I really like, he did a whole, like, hour video on the Ninja Turtles. He did it, he broke down on how to train, like, Vegeta and the Gravity Chambers. Like, videos like that's really neat, and he has a lot of energy for it. He shows that it's not like, yeah, you do this. No, he'll show you, he'll do it himself. And I really like that. Just like the energy he has, it's great. Jordan Taylor, is known for being on a channel called Blimey Cow. I like those videos, but I really like when it's Jordan's video on his channel. It's just him talking about stuff, like getting up at 5 a.m., him, building a new port, stuff like that, stuff I want to utilize in my own life. And I think that it kind of got better when his wife, Sarah, started helping. They did a video on, they were both homeschooled, so like, but how were they different? I really like that, I just like his personality. He's very humble, very down to earth, and I just like, it really shows. Julian Smith. Julian Smith has been on it for, since YouTube started. He made skits. He's made, like, the Hot Kool-Aid. He did, Eat Randy, the Ginger Snap. These skits that people will remember. My friends quote the lines all the time. But I just like his air of humor. I can influence my friends a lot to make skits. They're somewhere on the internet. I just really like it, and I haven't seen him do much. But hope you're doing well, man. Kel Loren. Kel Loren was someone I found trying to find how to find a job doing graphic design, because that's what I want to do while I'm in college, is study for graphic design. I think doing a YouTube channel really helps me find a way to expand and smooth out my process. I like how she, like, here's a logo, I'm going to redo it, make it look better. And it's not like she's like, this is a horrible logo. Like, some of them, yes. But some of it's just like, well, here's how we tweak it, make it fit more of the aesthetic. I really like how she does it. Again, like Benjamin Favish, she has this style of editing, like her, implicitly pretentious. The three of them have this very different style that I really like, and I try to utilize a little bit, but also try to do my own thing. I really like how she does her content. Microwave Society. These guys I found during quarantine. Again, they all started YouTube like me during quarantine. I started a little bit before, but three dudes that review a kid movie. And it's weird being an adult watching a kid movie, and they acknowledge it and just have fun. Make fun of it, and stuff like that. I like their VeggieTales stuff. Maybe one day we'll do something, guys. Monica L.R. Monica, I found finding Demon Hunter videos. I think it was when War and Peace came out. I wanted to see how it was being received. And I like how she acknowledges something bad in an album, but also something great in an album. I think that's what I really try putting in my own reviews. Like, I don't like the song, but I really do like this album. Like, I try to do it that way. I like how she's just sitting propped up against her door. I don't know. You don't have to have a fancy green screen, you don't have to have all the fancy stuff. If you get really big and you want to make your content look better for more people, go for it. But if you're just starting out, just stand in front of your door, or just sit in a chair, or just stand up on your bed with the camera, you know, like your phone, propped up on like a soda can on your dresser or something. Like, just do that. Nerds Inc. I think this was actually one of my first YouTube channels I found. I think he unboxed, it was like the Marvel Collector Core box. But I like his videos now. I love his Bob Ross video. It's just him talking about Bob Ross and kind of how his videos are styled. It's just him, against backdrop, and like, there are gaps in his videos where he releases, but I think that's something good about his content, is that he's able to make better content with the time that he's, you know, not making content. I know he's doing other things, I know he edits other people's videos as well, but I just love that, that Bob Ross video. I love his Superman video, the last one out for the Snyder Cut. I just love it. Just something. I think he's what really sparked me wanting to do YouTube. I think he was a college dropout as well. Like, him doing this in college, like, it kind of me like, yeah, I can still do this. Even if I'm still in college, which that's the plan. Shadiversity. Shadiversity was someone I found. I don't remember where I found him, but I like the idea of, like, the medieval stuff, and I like watching videos on it, but it's cool seeing him building a castle, building armor, and discussing, like, what are some inaccuracies, first concern I have the stuff in it, is it inaccurate? Is it accurate? Will this hammer work? Well, can you survive in a barrel? Nunchucks a good weapon. Is Captain America's shield reliable? I really like how that's done. And I just like, he's just sitting in his backyard, you know, like, he doesn't care who's watching. He's making a video, and I really like it, and I like the enthusiasm he has with it. Thew Adams was this guy I found through Facebook. Someone posted one of his videos, and he does Transformers reviews. They're like 5 minutes long. 10 minutes, like 5 to 10 minutes long. Him talking about a Transformer with like such enthusiasm. And he's been doing it since like 2007, so he's been doing it for a long time. All the links to all of you guys, I promise. The funny jokes he makes, and like some of the stories he tells, it's just this British guy just having loads of fun. That was the last one we're going to talk about. One podcast that's on here, and I guessed LiveWire from Decker Shadow. But this one's interesting. I like the idea of it. It's you guys talking to a random person in a grocery store aisle. And apparently a lot of them worked at that grocery store, so it's even better. Just them talking about stuff. And I really like that aesthetic. You see people just, you know, trying to get groceries, walk around these guys. Like, I really like something about that. There's another guy, they do it outside. I don't remember the names. I don't recall. But, I just really like that aesthetic. And just that idea. It's crazy off the wall people are going to watch it. They don't have a lot of videos, but they're all very enjoyable. But yeah. What are your guys' favorite YouTube? What influenced you? There's just some of them. I might make part two on some of the music on YouTube that's influenced me. Like the music creators. Maybe, I don't know, we'll see. But hope you guys enjoyed the Return of the Anything Extraneous podcast. You know, put in the comments what you want to see more. Ask me some questions. Maybe look at me at the videos. And someone's trying to text me, so we're going to call it an end. See you guys.